lot of teams had a lot of expectations placed on them before the 2021-2022 season. Unfortunately, man, it just didn't happen that way, and it hurts. I know it hurts if you're one of these teams' fans, man. Trust me. I've seen it on the up and up 1,000 times, man. I'm going to tell you who those five teams are that are the biggest disappointments, in my opinion, this season. I'm Rico McGee, and welcome to another episode of the Sports Minute. The top five teams in the NBA that were real disappointments despite the big hype surrounding them and that what they were expected to do didn't even turn out like that, Jack.
The Indiana Pacers had big expectations. Domantas Sabonis, Malcolm Brogdon, Miles Turner, T.J. Warren, and Caris LeVert were expected to lead the Pacers to prominence, or at least a sixth seed avoiding the play-in tournament, but the Pacers are terrible. 25-55 and sitting at the bottom of the league in pretty much every category. That is not going to get it done. Portland needs to just go ahead and rebuild. Just start that rebuild. Maybe last year they should have started. Maybe 2 years ago. But at 27-52, Damian Lillard hasn't been the player that he's been the last couple of years. Let's just be honest about it. His shot percentage has dropped, and he's just not that same player he was. He's been dealing with injuries. He's been out for most of the year. His former partner in crime, C.J. McCollum, missed the whole 2 months before being traded to the Pelicans. Now, Yusuf Nurkic will be an unrestricted free agent this summer, so I don't think he'll be coming back in a Blazer uniform. And honestly, I don't see Dame coming back neither. I think he's fed up. They have not put enough talent around him to win games. And I just think that's it for Portland, man. Real big disappointment this season. Tom Thibodeau's defensive mind and expertise turned the New York Knicks to a top five team in the East last season. They clinched the number four seed before falling in the first round. And they gave Knicks something to be excited about this year. Until they did. The New York Knicks sadly won't make the playoffs this year, not at 35-44. And I mean, let's just be honest. They still need a point guard and they need a legit leader and a solid number one option because Julius Randle ain't it. There, I said it. Now, the Atlanta Hawks were the team that eliminated the Knicks in the first round last season, and they knocked off the top seeded 76ers before falling to the Bucks in the East Finals. They have not lived up to expectations this year. I understand that John Collins has been hurt for most of the year, but that is no excuse. The Atlanta Hawks still have to get it done. Trae Young has still been amazing this season, but the defense has lacked heavily. They'll make the play-in tournament, but you do not want to play a healthy Nets team. If they do, say goodnight. Of course, we all have the Los Angeles Lakers as the most disappointing team of the NBA season. But if you're a real basketball head, you knew that roster was doomed from the start. But anyway, it's like the Lakers get blown out 2 to 3 times a week. You traded for Russell Westbrook instead of DeMar DeRozan. And injuries combined with age has just caught up to you. Father Time catches up to everybody. And LeBron James is no exception. I don't care how high a level he's playing. He cannot carry a team on his shoulders like he used to. Not saying that he can't, but he shouldn't have to at his age and at his point, man. At this point. Now, the Lakers are just a complete mess. They're going to miss the playoffs, and they are sitting at 31-48, man, which is at the bottom of the West, man. The Lakers have been probably one of the worst, if not the worst, teams in the league, and it just kind of sucks, man. I'm really, honestly, they don't have no more, I don't see a future, man. They're probably going to split ways with Frank Vogel, and we'll just see what happens, man. Hopefully LA can get it together, man. But why don't you let me know who's been a disappointment in your eyes, man? Put it in the comments, man. Continue to like, subscribe, and tell everybody what's going on, man. I'm Rico McGee. This has been the Sports Minute. And as always, in a minute.